Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach how to make the hospital management system step by step tutorial. Today is the part 2 video. In our last class we saw how to create the user type. In this class I am going to teach the login form. So let's select the package. This is the package. Right click, new JFrame form. Here I am going to create a new form as login. Click finish. Right. Now your frame has created successfully. Right. Now here I am going to design the login form. So get the panel from the palette. Drag here. Right. Now here I am going to right click properties. Select the border property. Select a title border. Here I am going to write the title as login. Font I am going to increase as 14 with bold. Click OK. Now I am going to change the background color of the panel. So go to the property background here. Click on this one. We have to change this color. Click OK. Right. Now if you feel to change the title color here, so let's again click on the border property color here. This one, change it as a white. Right. Now click OK. It will appear. Okay. If you want to change any thing about the border, you right click and properties. If you make the changes here, it won't change. You click on the border property here, you will be able to change. If you want to change the title or color or font, you will be able to do like this. Right. Click OK. Now I need two fields, labels, two labels, three labels. Right. This one for username. This one for password. This one for user type. Now select username and select hold on the control key and select username, and after that select password and user type. You have to select these three labels and right click properties, go to the font property. Here I am going to bit bold. I am going to increase size as 12. Click OK. Now I am going to change the font color as foreground color as, this one should be yellow. Click OK. Right. Now close it. Right. Perfect. Now here I am going to drag the relevant text box. This one for username. Here I am going to change the text box as password field. This one for the password type, username password. This one for user type. So I am going to get it as a combo box. So here J combo, as a J combo here. After that we need one button, two buttons. One is exit, another one is a this one for login. Right click login. This one button for login. I have to get another button from the palette. This one for cancel. Right click cancel. Oh, exit. Exit. Right. This two button. Right. Now let's click on this button. Select this field. Right click edit text. Backspace to remove the default text. And right click change variable. I am going to change the name of the text box as txt username. Click on this field, right click, edit text, backspace to remove. Select again this field, right click, change variable txt pass. Click OK. Now select this one, user type, right click, properties. Here we have to change the property as this one, model. Here we have to, this is default item we have to remove. Instead of that, we have to type the things. So first one should be, I am going to write as a pharmacist. First one should be pharmacist. Second one should be doctor. Third one should be receptionist. Now what I'm going to do is, here we have to change the user change variable txt utype, mean user type. Click OK. Right, now I successfully designed the form. Now I'm going to go to write the code. So select the we have to go to the source first. We have to write the connection. So let's back to our user.java and source. We already write the connection, all the stuff here. After the constructor, we have create this connection object, all the stuff. You have to copy them, right? So copy and back to my page, login page, and paste after the constructor, this constructor. Right, click OK. Perfect. Right, perfectly done. Right, it's perfectly done. Right. If you paste, it's automatically create the relevant namespaces. Right, perfectly. Right. Once you done in this form, the same thing you have to copy and paste it. Okay, instead of writing again by again, it take too much time to complete the project. Right, perfect. After that, what I'm going to do is, here I successfully connect to the MySQL Server database. Now here I'm going to check the condition. If the username and password correct, only again it is check the user type. Okay, if the user type is correct, it is the login will be successfully login to the main form. Right, let's how to do, let's do the task. So let's select the login button, right click, event, action, action perform. Here I'm going to write the code. Here is first I'm going to write, first we have to equal into this three text boxes into the relevant variables. So first create a string, call a string, string data type username equal txt username dot text. Right, after that string password equal to txt password dot edx. Txt password, why if it is not coming as a green, your name you given is a wrong. So here txt password dot edx. Right, after that you have to check the user type. String u type equal into txt u type dot get selected item, get selected collected item dot toString. Now here what I'm going to do is, here I'm going to check the condition after that. Right, here first I'm going to write as a pst for prepare statement object. We have to con dot prepare statement, we have to write the query for checking. So on dot prepared statement, we have to write select all from user table, all the field from user table where username equal into question mark and password equal into question mark and user type is user type equal into question mark. So u type equal into question mark, we have to check these three. Right, so here it show the error. So here we have to complete the statement. So here select this one and import the try with catch right. So effective. After that, what I'm going to do is here I'm going to write the set into the prepare statement. So set string, first one should be username. Control C, copy, control V, paste here. Same thing, control C, copy, control V, paste here. Second question mark should be password, this password. Right. When the user enter the username and password on these text box, it's passing to the relevant variables here. It's, I'm going to take it to this place. It's go to this question mark and check, right? Check into the relevant columns, these two columns. Username and password, these columns. So you have to go into these two columns, right? The same name you have to enter here. What are the name of the name you created columns, right? After that, you type, user type, you have to type right here. This one, you type, complete copy, paste here. This one should be 3, right? After that, what I am going to do is here, we have to create another stuff is a resource set. So you type resource set, not here, RS. The efficient way to create the resource set, you control X to cut off this one, paste it above after the prepare statement here, right? It's a efficient way to create the resource set. So what is the error here? This is a case sensitive. You have to resource set, this S should be capital, that should be there, right? Import the Java SQL resource set, right? Now perfect. Now here you have to check resource set to check rs dot equal pst dot execute query. Now here we have to check if rs dot next right here. First I am going to load the ID from the database, right? This ID, user ID, right? This user ID mean, what's the type user ID I have created? Int, integer type. So I can't write as a string, okay? You have to write as an integer, right? So here get int user ID equal to rs dot get int. Here we have to specify the column name is the user ID. But I give the user ID from the databases. What is the user ID? If you enter the username and password and user type, the username and password and user type is matching to which ID, that ID will be getting here and passing to the relevant variable, right? When I log into the system, it goes to the data, your username and user type along with the ID to your main phone. That's why I take the ID, right? Which user login, right? So here, after that, the current form should be hide. So what I have to do is, current form is login form. When the user is correctly logged in, so this dot, you can set visible false. You can write like this. If the user name and password correct. So here we have to send which form, we have to send it to this main form. If the username and password correct, we have to go to the main form, right? So we have to write new main here. If the username correct, which values we are going to pass? Username, password, sorry, username and user type and along with the ID. So you have to write here is, first thing you have to write user ID, this variable. After that we have to write second one is a username, password. So the username comma password, right? Now if you type like this here, there will be the error show here on the left, right? This error, if you write like this, these are called as a parameter. The same parameter should be should be, we have to create on the main method, right? Here we are going to send these values to which page? Main page. I give the name as main page. In on the main page, these values should retrieve from the main page. Okay, this value should return retrieve from main page. So let's go to the main.java, go to the source. This is the parameters we have, right? Public main, this one, same parameters, control C to copy, control V to paste below. Here we have to receive the argument. So how to receive the values? We have to write the same thing, int id comma string. You have to write username, you have to retrieve the values, comma string user type, u type. That's the stuff we have to write. Initialize component, it is must. Okay, if you copy this constructor with initial component, right, that will be the must. When the form is initialized, these things will be happen, right? So now let's back to your form. Here now the error go away, but if you create the argument here, okay, if you are sending to these values into this main form, main form will be receiving to like this. This is the way it will receiving. After that, what I'm going to do is, here I'm going to create the variables on the top. So here I'm going to create as new id. I just like the create the variables new id here. After that, you have to create the inner string variable, string username. You write as a username, uname. You have to give the different name. This one should be, you have to give as a different string user type. Now I get the values and equal into these relevant variables, right? That's why I have created the different variables above, right? The same variable, if you create the same name, it's difficult to identify. So I have created the different name to get the variable and equal into this variable. So I'm going to get this one. So if you write here, you have write using the this keyword, this dot this form, this dot this form. We have to get restring the variable for this form, so that we have to call the write this keyword dot this side, which I this side is not this side, is this one, this dot the username dot username equal, you have this username, control C copy, control V to paste here, right? You have to equal to look like this, right? After that, we have to get another thing, user type. So this dot this user type, user type equal into user type, right? What are the values coming here? It is assigned to these variables, right? After that, this id we have to get it. After that, this dot new id equal into id. That's the stuff we have to do. That's the thing we have to do. Perfect. Perfectly done the stuff. Now what I am going to do is, here this all the stuff are correct. Now I am going to, when the form is when the user is logged in successfully, here I am going to pass into this values into the username and user type into relevant labels. Okay, this one labeled 4, this one should be labeled 5. So you look right, get the username and pass into labeled 4, sorry, J label. Text equal into which one? Username. Pass into this username. This one. You have to control C copy. Delete paste here. Here this username. Right? This username you have to pass it. Get the username here and pass into this relevant variable. We are passing here. Same thing. Control C copy, Control V to paste below. Here user type, this user type. Control C copy, Control V to paste. Right. ID, we won't pass any here, anything here. I have to store in this variable only. Right. Now let's check whether it's working fine or not. Let's back to our login page. Now here we didn't complete the login page yet, right? Now here these values, if the login successfully, these values be goes to the main form, right, along with the ID. If the user enter the wrong username and password, invalid login. So here we have to write as a G option pan. We have to display the error message. G option pan dot show message. This dot this out right here is username and password. User name or password do not match. Do not match. Look right there. This like this. Perfect. After that, we have to clear the login login form. So txt user name dot set text. After that, same thing, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste here, txt, pass, set clear, this one clear, Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste below, here, after that, we have to, username, you have to set as a, you no need to, user type also, if you want to clear user type also, txt, to type, dot, set, selected index, clear the form and cursor will be focused on the txt user name dot request box. That's the stuff we have to do. Right, perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here, let me check whether it's working fine or not. Now let's go to the default configuration, customize. I'm going to set as a login form. So when the project is running, which form we have to call first, we have to give here, right? Here run, you have to give here login the form. This form should be when you run this project, this is the first form we have to run, so that we have to give here. Let's run the project and check. Here it's not come at the center, it's not proper. So let's select the login frame, not panel. You are not check the select the panel, select the frame. It's a frame. Right click, properties, code, generator, center. If you select the frame panel, it's not proper. Select the frame. Frame should be display, right? Not panel should be display at the center. Frame should be display. Okay, right, let's run the program. It's perfectly at the center when the project is run. Perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here I'm going to write the username and password. Now I just write something like that. Click login. Here what's the problem? So login. The problem is this. We haven't called the connection. Control C to copy this connection. We have to paste it here. Right. Then save. Right. Okay. That's the problem. I have established a connection. I haven't called the connection. If it is not here, you just remove it. This connection easily you have to call. Control C to copy. You have to call it when the form is initialized. Come after the initialization component. Right. You have to call it here. Right. This constructor. After initialization, initial component mean when the form is loaded, this component should be called. After we along with the component, the connection should be called so that the connection will be established right when the form is loaded. Right. Now let's check. That's the problem. Now I'm going to enter the username and password. Click login. Here it's working properly. Username or password do not match. Right now I forgot the username and password. Let's go to the right. First, I'm going to log in the user as a receptionist. So this is the username John, password 123. Okay, John is the username, password 123. User type, I'm going to select as receptionist. Click login. What's happened? Nothing to happen. Right now, okay, the problem is here. If it is success, current shown phone should be false. This main form, I have to give a set disabled. Only this form should be shown. If you give the set visible, right? This is not error. It show like this. Right? Now let's run the program and check. Right now here I'm going to run as a current form is what is the username? John 123. Sorry, John 123 receptionist. Click login here. Here the field is only, what is the problem, 1, 2, 3, what is the problem, ID, username and password. So not a password, man, this one should be the user type. Sorry, the problem is my root type. Can you see the copy? If the password is shown, it's not a proper way. I have wrote not a password here, uname, user type, right? Username, user type, right? So here user type, here it's correct. Here we have set it here as correct user type, root type, username, password. There I be right now. Now let's run the project and check. John 123 receptionist login. It's receptionist user type. User, what's the problem here? It's not set at. User ID, username, as a username entered here, it's not scored. What is the problem? User type, like here it's username, here user type as a 5, that's a problem, right? This one should be 5, right? I have called two labels as label 4, that's a problem, right? Now let's run. Now it's working. John, password, receptionist, log here. It's logged successfully. Username as log John, receptionist, user type as a reception. If you want to increase the size, it will be possible to increase the size. So let's select this one, right click, properties, font, increase as a 80. Click OK. This one should be 80. Now let's log as a different user. Let's see, as a doctor, Raja, right? Here I have Raja 123 doctor login, right? Perfectly, it's done, right? I hope you guys understood the login form well. In my next tutorial, I'm going to teach how to create the patient, right? Thank you for watching. If you like my channel, subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.